the company that bought you the funniest animated spoofs of the year, like Power.
I told you to teach me the game, Ghost. Now look at you, all fucked up.
To riveting documentaries.
I sold my soul to the devil. I know it's a crappy deal. Lisa came with a few toys like a Happy Meal.
To raw daily news.
While taking pictures, a flying Negro appears out of nowhere, drop-kicking a Terminator in his back.
To our animated rap battle league.
Right from the jump, they'll bang on you, Nate Robb.
We can't forget about Hood Times. One of our most extraordinary animated remakes to ever hit the web is definitely
Dynamite.
So if you never heard of Indiana Animated TV, you must have been living under a rock. Or on rock.
That bitch smoking crack? Oh, hell nah.
So tune in, watch, subscribe, Indian Animated TV, oh yeah.
What's up YouTube, it's your boy Mark Dart, and I'm back with another Power video. If you're new, if you love Power, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, like the video, leave your comments, theories, everything down below. Tonight, we're going to be talking about it, man. This is the final predictions for Power Season 6. This is Episode 10, the mid-season finale. And it could be the finale for some characters tonight in this episode, man. I cannot wait to talk about it with you guys. I'm going to give you my final predictions. You guys let me know what are your final predictions down in the comment section. Now, let's begin, man, because this has been a hell of a season. I mean, we had ups and downs. And trust me, I know a lot of people was upset with some episodes with the writing. But at the same time, we all family. We all here because we want to see how this all ends. And hopefully, it can end well, man. Hopefully, it don't be no Game of Thrones type shit. And it can actually end the season off well. So let's talk about it, man. Now, we see your boy Cedric the Entertainer. Now, he is rumored to be in this next episode. I can't tell you if it's 100% true, but I do see him coming eventually. In Power, especially because he's associated with CBS. You know he has a show on CBS. So usually they like to, you know, switch characters from other shows. Like Lala going to The Chi. That's a CBS show. So usually they like switching out characters. The question is, what will be Cedric the Entertainer's role in the show? I don't know, man, but he will be coming eventually. Maybe in the next episode. So my final predictions, let's start this off. Your boy Ghost and Tasha. Because everybody wants to know the final betrayal. Who is going to be the final betrayal? Or what is going to be the final betrayal? All I know is this. I see Ghost with a game plan. You know, I predict him, as just like in the trailer. Yes, he's apologizing to Tasha, telling her, you know, everything is good. He's sorry for what he did. But it's going to be some new problems happening. I feel like they won't name this episode No One Can Stop Me for no reason. So I feel like Ghost is going to have a very successful episode, at least early on in the episode. I feel like the episode is going to be dominated by Ghost. I think he's going to be countering everything that they bring his way, and then something's going to happen. Now, we know Tariq is going to have problems, so I predict Tariq's problem probably to be something to do with school, something to do with Ghost pretty much calling the feds on the shop, and the school knows about it or whatever, or it can be with Ghost running for governor. It's going to be something connected to this. Tariq is telling Ghost, you lied to my face. So apparently it's probably something that Ghost did. He told Tariq circumstances have changed. So I'm predicting something to be, for as Tariq, it has to be like schooling, you know, Ghost running for governor or something to do with Mr. Radner. It's something. That's all I can say. That's all I think that's going to happen. They still haven't shown us enough to actually make a good prediction on this storyline. But we know Tariq is always in trouble. So most likely it's going to be something that Ghost is going to have to change the game plan on. And that Tariq is not going to like. Now, my predictions for Tommy and Ghost. Because they act like the two is going to kill each other the whole season. They've been going back and forth, back and forth. I always predicted that neither person would kill each other. That's too predictable. And let's just say Tommy kills Ghost or Ghost kills Tommy. It's not really a surprise factor to none of the fans. They've been trying to kill each other the whole damn season, so it's not really a surprise factor. I think that they want to give us something that's shocking. So whoever kills Tommy or Ghost is going to probably be someone else. That's my prediction. Now, we know Ghost and Tommy will be going somewhere. And I think they're going to be going to a place talking about that recording that Joe Proctor had, that Alisa Marie has. And maybe it's connected. You know, maybe, as I made that video earlier, earlier this week about that audio, it's going to be connected to somebody. Tommy will find out, and it's going to be a major thing. And I think the two are probably going to work together and try to figure out what's going on. Now, when it comes to Rashad Tate, yes, he's going to try to do whatever he has to do to beat Ghost. Ghost tells him, look, you used to losing. So I predict Rashad Tate to try something. Of course, Rashad Tate is not going to go out like that. Rashad Tate is definitely going to try to make a maneuver on Ghost. I predict Ramona to try her best to save Ghost. She's been, you know, here trying to protect him low key. You know, the last episode, Rashad Tate said loyalty is a good characteristic that any man will want. And of course, that's something that Ramona is going to try to show to Ghost. She's going to try to protect him. Now, Ghost is going to try and probably prevail at countering anything Rashad Tate brings. But I think something else is up with your boy Rashad Tate. This is about to get ugly. I'm telling you, it's about to get ugly. They've been building up. Have y'all been noticing his facial expressions and the way he's looking? He's looking darker each episode. Rashad Tate, he's willing to snitch on anybody as of right now, especially your boy Ghost. So I can expect Rashad Tate to tell them probably about that robbery and say that James St. Patrick set it up or something else. I don't really know what else Rashad Tate knows. We know that dude that he had spying on Ghost, his name, I think it was Will. He probably got some dirt, but Rashad Tate is definitely going to tell Cooper Sacks and Blanca Rodriguez that Ghost is up to something, that, you know, James St. Patrick is Ghost and that he's dirty. Like I said, only thing I know for sure is that robbery. He probably would say, well, they set that up. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to find out exactly where that goes. I know a lot of people have been asking me about 2-Bit and the watch that Ghost had or whatever that he stole from Ghost, that may come back up. So we just got to wait and see. Now, I know everybody's wondering about this cell phone. Now, was Ghost able to get this cell phone? My predictions for this, I think it's like 50-50. I think it's a high chance that Ghost is able to get this cell phone or, you know, able to counter whatever the feds are going to bring his way. It's just, to me, I feel like everybody's coming at him. So he's going to try his best to counter, you know, why would you name it? No one can stop me. So as you see right here, you see the boys, and you know with these trailers, they can switch it up and make it seem like it's something else. But I feel like your boy Ghost knows the boys is coming. I feel like he know they coming to probably search him. I could be wrong, but I feel like he's going to be watching and he's going to be ready for their move. As you can see right here, he's looking. So is he looking at the boys is the question, or is he looking at somebody else? You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I think it's 50-50 with that cell phone. And you guys, as I told you earlier this week, that cell phone got some information on there. I can't wait to find out exactly what it is. It's going to lead to somebody else. Is it Tasha? We're going to see, man. We're going to see. Now, Dre, I predict him to come for Ghost. He's going to try everything in his power to stop Ghost, because Ghost tried to set him up with Jason about the killing of Jason and everything like that. So y'all saw last episode, Dre trying to link up with Cooper Sacks, or linking up with Cooper Sacks, working with him like they're best friends. So bitch-ass Dre is going to try his best to take out Ghost. The only way I see Dre not doing that, if Ghost offers him something. What can Ghost offer Dre to stop him? I guess we got to wait and see. But I know everybody been talking about that California Connect. Remember that California Connect that Jason was talking about? Maybe somebody can make a deal with him. Now, Dre doesn't know him, and I don't think Ghost does either. So maybe Tommy will be working with that dude. But we're going to talk about that later. Tasha, will she betray Ghost? Will she fully betray? I mean, they pretty much betrayed each other already. But this is the final betrayal. So it's got to be big, right? It got to be real big. Ghost, he's been showing elements of the old Ghost at times. If this was season 2 Ghost, no one would definitely stop him. It'd be easy work for him. The new Ghost that we're seeing, which they've been saying since the beginning of Power, we're pretty much seeing a different type of person. We know that he's still the same, but as far as taking out enemies, he's different. He's very different to me. I felt like in season 2, he did a lot of smart shit that he's showing us a little bit of that in season 6. So hopefully in this episode, he gives us the full version of his true potential. He knows someone is coming for him. He knows he got heat on him. You know he's going to have the strap. And I'll expect your boy Ghost to try his best to get the victory. Remember, Ghost is supposed to be 3-4 steps ahead of the game. Big Rich Town theme song is about him. Will he win? Will his son try to take him out? Will your boy Tommy try to do it? I feel like the two are brothers. I think Tommy's going to think about killing Ghost. Remember in that little scene that I showed you, Ghost is telling Tommy like, well, I don't know if you're going to let me live or walk out this place alive. We know Rashad Tate is coming for Ghost. Will he be able to get him? You know what I'm saying? Dre also, as I just talked about, will be coming for him. But I feel like Ghost may offer Dre something. If you guys been noticing, every time Dre and Ghost go at it, they always come to a compromise and they work things out. So maybe they are able to do that again. I say Dre's bitch ass can't be trusted. And then we got Tasha. We seen what she did last episode. Is she still pissed off about what happened? Is she willing to fully betray Ghost at the highest level? We know Cooper Sacks is coming for Ghost as well. I expect him to fail. I don't think he's going to be able to get Ghost. But remember, as I told you guys, Cooper Sacks, he owes Ghost. Ghost spared him his life. So maybe he actually gives Ghost some information and saves him in the long run. We got to wait and see how it all plays out. This episode is going to be crazy, y'all. I'm telling y'all right now, this could be it, man. This can be one of the last times we see your boy Ghost, man. Tommy alive. Paz is coming back, and I know a lot of you guys been saying she's probably coming back to see what's going on with Angela's killer. Probably coming back to collect money. Who really knows, but she will be back. And they actually got your girl Angela casted for this episode. So maybe it's just that ghost shit that she did in episode 4 or whatever. But Paz is coming back. Will that cell phone she put in Angela's casket come back? Now that's a huge question. And your boy Ghost, with everybody against him, will he be able to win? I mean, it's a whole lot of different theories and everything going on. In this episode, we should be able to get all those answers. All the main pop storylines should be answered tonight in this episode. We know Benny is dead. We know that Audio will come back up. What about Kate Egan? What about all these other characters, man? It's about to be a war. I think, hopefully, they end this shit right, man. I hope they end this shit right. Cedric the Entertainer is rumored to be in this episode. What role will he play in this? Will he be somebody that's in the game? You know, somebody that can help Ghost or Tommy? Who really knows? And to end off the prediction video, my prediction is this, man. My final prediction. I feel like at the end of this, as I told you at the beginning of the season, we pretty much know that Tommy and Ghost is going to continue to go at each other, but it's too obvious to say, oh, Tommy's going to kill Ghost, Ghost's going to kill Tommy. That's not surprising to us. So I feel like, as I was telling Jay Moore Reviews the other day, them continuing to kill off main characters, is that good TV? You know what I'm saying? I mean, how many main characters can you kill off and say this is great? So in my opinion, I think, just like I believe at the beginning of the season, that it's going to be a major plot twist. It ain't going to go the way a lot of people thinking it's going to go. They're going to try something. I just don't think killing off everybody is going to work. So I see somebody going to jail, and I do see a big character possibly dying, whether it's Dre, Cooper Sacks. I mean, it could be Tommy. It could be Ghost, y'all. This could be it. Just think about that for a second. We've been watching Power for 6 years, and tonight's episode, it can probably be the end of Ghost. It can probably be the end of your boy Tommy. Will it be the end? You know what I'm saying? Will it be the end for those two characters? I feel like the show is nothing without the two, man. And I know I talk about I want my boy Ghost to survive, but at the end of the day, Tommy makes the show too. And they know that, and they know that Tommy's character, along with Ghost together, brings in so much viewership. If you've been noticing, this has probably been the most sponsored season of Power since the beginning. They've got this show promoted everywhere. If you go to New York, I was in New York over the summer, it was promoted everywhere, in airports, on buses, in subways, at different businesses. This show is promoted everywhere. So, with that saying, are they ready to let go of all that potential? I just don't think so. I think they're going to try to do something where it's a big plot twist at the end where they're going to make us and drag us into next year and make us want to see how it ends. If they kill off Ghost, hey, they kill him off. But hey, they're going to have a lot of, you know, story to make up for. They're going to have to answer to a lot of fans because a lot of people will be pissed, you know what I'm saying, that he was going to die, or even if Tommy does. But I think people are expecting Tommy to die more than Ghost based off the stuff that Tommy has been through. He's been through a lot, man. A whole lot, killing everybody, losing everybody. Both characters have been through a lot. So just to kill him off, I don't think that's the best way to do it. I think we need a huge plot twist, and I think we're going to get it tonight. I think we're going to get it. But I say this, someone's going to jail. That's a damn fact. I guarantee you someone is going to jail. But you guys leave your predictions, everything down below. I know I make this video kind of long, but it's been a hell of a journey, y'all. A hell of a journey. I almost feel like this is the end because I almost feel like the last 5 episodes is not going to be what we think. But then again, I guess I got to wait and see. But if it is the end of Ghost and Tommy, it's been a hell of a journey for you guys. And I can't wait to continue the story to see how it all ends. But keep supporting your boy. I will continue to bring you more power content in the future. I will be dropping a video for you guys early tomorrow. Just talking about a storyline. And then I will see you guys tomorrow night for the recap of the mid-season finale. But like I said, leave your predictions, theories. What are your final predictions? Who will be the final betrayal? Leave it down below. Keep supporting your boy, and I will catch y'all on the next one. But it's your boy, Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.